Joe Biden's age, of course, was already a talking point before the debate. It was amplified as well, not just in a cognitive sense. Plenty of discussion online about this footage of the First Lady, Jill Biden, helping her 81-year-old husband off stage. You can see pretty small steps there, but having to be helped off. He clearly needed assistance to descend those steps to greet the two CNN moderators after that. So I'm sure that'll be images played as well. Let's get more reaction. CNN reporter Julia Benbrook has been good enough to join us live. Julia, thank you very much for your time. I know it's late over there. First of all, how are people, the voters, reacting to tonight's debate performance?
Well, it will be interesting to see what the reaction is like tomorrow. These two candidates came into this debate essentially tied in nationwide polls. But we are hearing some reaction. There are some Democratic Party officials who have privately expressed concern about Biden's performance in this debate, citing some of those more shaky moments that he had. There was an interview with Vice President Kamala Harris on CNN shortly after the debate where she said it's not about these 90 minutes, it's about the last 3.5 years and the work that their administration has done for the American people. But when she was really pressed about his performance, she admitted that he got off to a, quote, slow start.
Yeah, okay. And in terms of the standout moments, what did you see them as this evening?
Well, there were quite a few. They talked about everything from serious topics like abortion rights to their golf game. These two were also asked about their age. They're only a few years apart. Now, it's typically Biden's age that gets discussed, but they would both be the oldest president on their swearing-in day. And so both of them tried to say, yes, I'm fit for office. I am ready to go. When it comes to abortion rights, that had been a key part of Biden's re-election campaign. He says that he wants to codify parts of Roe v. Wade. Trump, on the other hand, is proud of the fact that Roe v. Wade was overturned and spoke about the three conservative Supreme Court justices that he appointed. On immigration, they both say that the border should be more secure, but Trump says that Biden's not doing enough, and Biden says that Trump, in part, tried to stop a bipartisan agreement that they had to strengthen the border.
They are two very different candidates. What about their preparation? How did that differ?
So very different preparation, very different performances, very different candidates. You had Biden at Camp David for about the last week in discussions, intense discussions, and mock debate prep. Trump has kind of shunned this formal debate prep philosophy, and he has participated in some informal briefing sessions, but he kept a pretty regular campaign schedule leading up to this with interviews and rallies. Went about it very different ways. His team really encouraged him, Trump's team really encouraged him to stray away from airing grievances tonight and instead focus in on issues like crime, inflation, and the economy. Biden's team encouraged him to paint Trump as unfit for office, and we saw them both attempt to do those things. Biden's team also wanted him to focus in on things like abortion rights, the economy, and democracy.
Yeah, okay. Now, a big moment, but it's also one that's come well out from the election, indeed the first debate, before the candidacy is actually confirmed. So what is next in this cycle?
There's a lot coming up, and this election year has a lot to it. Trump is actually going to have his sentencing for his hush money trial in New York on July 11th, in just a few weeks. And he was convicted of 34 felony counts of falsifying business records. Then he turns around quickly and goes to the Republican National Convention. There, he has said that's where he plans to announce his running mate. So lots of eyes on that. Then in August, you have the Democratic National Convention. And then these two candidates have agreed to a second debate. That's scheduled for September 10th on ABC.
All right, so that will be another appointment viewing moment. Julia Benbrook, appreciate your time. Thank you.